Namaskar. Vanakkam, Vandanam, Suswagatam. Welcome to a whole new trucking experience. And thank you for all being here today. BharatBenz is a story that goes back more than 5 years. 5 years of hard work. Started with many engineers, designers, experts, but most importantly, many amongst you are responsible for BharatBenz trucks being launched here today. Thank you very much. To take you through the experience is my pleasure here today. Take a look.
Prakrityam swajane shuja prasanna chito naraha yatna to hi sadhara param kashta prapadyate.
Only when one cares can one comprehend. Only when one comprehends can one innovate. Only when one innovates can one excel. Change existing paradigms and make things truly better for people. The philosophy which has led to the creation of products and a brand dedicated to India. BharatBenz. From the world leader in trucking, Daimler. The foundation was laid by the vision of two extraordinary men, Gottlieb Daimler and Carl Benz, who invented the very first automobile and then went on to give many firsts in innovations. A passion that soon manifested itself world over, making the very name Daimler synonymous with excellence for over 125 years. As the need for infrastructure building and efficient transportation in India becomes critical, BharatBenz is rising to meet this challenge. By first taking the utmost care to get a deep understanding of Indian road conditions and a deeper understanding of Indian truckers.
Jada power matlab delivery time pe.
Suspension acha ho to badan dikhne. चढ़ाओ पे कोई दिक्कत ना हो,
मालिक तो जरूरी है।
बार बार ब्रेक तो बड़े ही परेशान हो गए।
The insights derived from the study has resulted in innovations, specially for this market, leading to technologically superior products. BharatBenz is bred from the genes of two renowned names, Mercedes-Benz, leaders in heavy-duty trucks, and Fuso, front-runners in light-duty trucks. All this has culminated in a total commitment to India with a hub of excellence. Set up as a world-class manufacturing facility in Oragadam, Chennai. The facility has a state-of-the-art test track. Hitex has seen lakhs and lakhs of kilometers of rigorous testing. To ensure reliability and robustness in the toughest of conditions. Best-in-class trucks that deliver better fuel efficiency, greater pulling power and gradability, and high reliability and durability, with more safety and comfort, enhancing productivity. BharatBenz trucks come to the customer through an all-India network of dealers. After-sales service with 24/7 on-road assistance, advanced vehicle diagnostics, and more. Further, at an integrated training facility, all personnel get to enhance their skills with advanced training techniques. Thus, BharatBenz will provide customers a revolutionary trucking experience, giving them the power to be more competitive, to make their businesses more productive and efficient, to realize greater profits than ever before. BharatBenz. Power ahead.
Very interesting indeed. To take you back in time and tell you more about how BharatBenz evolved, it is my pleasure to invite on stage Mr. VRV Sri Prasad, the Vice President, Marketing, Sales and After Sales. Mr. Sri Prasad.
Thank you, Shankar Guruji. Good morning and namaskar. A warm welcome to all of you. Today is a historic day for BharatBenz. We believe that will also be a very important day for the Indian trucking industry. We have prepared for this day for the last 4 to 5 years, very meticulously planning for this day. We naturally are proud to show you what we have today, to share with you what we have done in the last 4 years or 5 years. Esteemed guests, thank you so much for honoring us by your presence today. In the next couple of minutes, I'll be taking you through this journey of BharatBenz, the story of how did we make BharatBenz, the making of the BharatBenz. To start that story, I need to take you back in time. Daimler's association with India goes a long way back. 1954, to be precise, when Daimler, in a joint venture with Tata Motors, brought out India's first heavy commercial vehicle. 60 years have gone by. 60 years is a long time. Indian roads have seen millions of trucks now. Many manufacturers have come. Many new models have been launched. But still, and in this period, Daimler also actively disengaged their association with Tata Motors. But even after 60 years, when you go across the country, when you stop a trucker, and why, with many of you, you still, whenever you see a Tata truck on Indian roads, you refer to it as a Benz truck. Thank you, India, for continuing to remember us. More recently, around 5 years back, Daimler took another important decision, a decision of re-engaging and renewing its association with India. So a team was formed. Some of us here and a few colleagues from Europe joined us. We traveled extensively across the length and breadth of the country, literally Kashmir to Kanyakumari and from Ahmedabad to Assam. We traveled on the roads, we traveled on the trucks, and some of us drove the trucks. All of us have licenses, we drove the trucks. We went through all the roads, Gujarat and Rajasthan, extreme climates. We drove through flooded roads, we drove through rain. It gave us very valuable experience. We understood how difficult was the life of a driver who spent most of his time in the truck. We also saw very many things. We ate in the dhabas. We spent hours together, 4 or 5 hours at a time, sitting patiently at the sales tax and octroi nakas. We saw many unpleasant things. We saw overloading. We saw harassment by the officials. We saw fuel pilferage, diesel pilferage. We saw diesel adulteration. And unfortunately, we also saw a lot of accidents and some deaths too. It was very unpleasant. But then this experience gave us a resolve. When we came back and sat together, we were clear as Daimler that we could do something, we could really impact the way trucking is done in this country. And then the decision was taken that we'll go to India on our own. We'll go and see how we can change, influence the way trucking is done in India. Having that been decided, we then started to look at what products should we be bringing here. We had a wide choice in Daimler. We chose two platforms. For the heavy commercial vehicles, we chose the successful Mercedes-Benz Axer platform, which continued to be a hot seller in Europe and the rest of the globe. For the LDT, we picked the Canter from Fuso, again a very popular LCV vehicle. Having chosen these two models, we could have just brought them, imported them and started selling in India. But then, that wouldn't have made it BharatBenz. We couldn't have claimed them, those trucks, to be BharatBenz. They would have just been an Axer and a Canter imported and sold. We had to convert these vehicles into BharatBenz. So we decided that we had to do three things. We had to have trucks which were made for India. That is number one objective. Second objective, we had to have these trucks made in India. That was the second one. And the third, a much larger objective was, we had to make a difference to you, the customers, and to all the stakeholders by reaching these trucks to you in a very different way, that it makes more sense for you, makes a difference to you. So the first thing, how did we go about making these trucks for India? One of the first things we did in this country, when we signed the MOU with the government of Tamil Nadu, and we got the land allotted at Oragadam in Chennai, even before a single brick could be put into making an office or a factory, the test track was the first civil construction that was done in the factory. For more than 2 years now, we've been testing our trucks. We've been testing them day and night, 24/7. We have an army of more than 100 drivers doing only testing of trucks. Not only in the test track, we've been taking our trucks out into the roads, into the highways, into crowded roads, into the cities, up the guard sections, driving them in rain, driving them in the night, and then experiencing and seeing how our performance is. And also at every time comparing it with competition trucks which we buy and test also along with our trucks. 45 lakh kilometers of testing what we have done. Testing is a religion, it's a discipline in Daimler. We still are continuing testing. In fact, we have brought 3 of our trucks for you to drive and see as part of this program today. And these trucks have been driven from Chennai to here by my colleague, Mr. Chakmas, who is the Vice President of R&D. He himself has driven these trucks from Chennai to here. So when we say we are testing, we are not leaving it to somebody else. I test the trucks. I go and drive the trucks. Many times in the mornings, I drive the trucks in the test track and then give feedback. Another very important thing we did as part of the testing, not just testing the trucks alone. During the testing period, we brought drivers, mechanics and bodybuilders from across India, from Indore, from Ahmedabad, from Kolkata, Vijayawada, Salem, Namakkal, from all these places, we brought these people to the factory, showed them the trucks, took their opinion, and that was invaluable. The suggestion given by the drivers, the mechanics and the bodybuilders was invaluable. I'll just like to cite to you three examples. Almost all of them, driver, mechanic and bodybuilders, very clearly told us the single largest pain area in a truck today is the suspension. Each one of them were impacted and had some problem because of suspension. So they said, if you guys can do something about the suspension, it will be of great help for us in this country. Today we will show you later what we have done about the suspension and how that will make a difference to all of you. Second, we learnt a lot from these people. The drivers taught one important thing which made our designers go mad. When we showed them the cabin, they said, "Hey, nahi chalega. I have to carry two tarpal and ropes, so yeh nahi chalega." So we said, okay, now let's understand how to do. When they were there, we brought new tarpals and tried putting them in to see how we can provide space. Then they said, no, yeh nahi chalega. It is very easy to fold a new tarpal. Bring a old tarpal in, then you'll know how difficult it is to fold it and how much space is required. Excellent. We would have never thought of it. As a designer, we can never think of it. This is practical. And we did that with their presence. We did that. And we had to redesign our complete cabins. 350 kgs more on the roof. We understood when we were designing this one more thing. It is not tarpal weight and the rope weight. The driver or the cleaner go up on top of the cabin to put it in place. So the person's weight also had to be taken into account. So we had to redesign the cabin for 350 kgs more load on the roof. This we would have never done if these people had not shared their information with us. Drivers, they gave us a lot of feedback. When you see the trucks, you will understand the small things. It did not cost us money what the drivers wanted. Small things they asked, which we have provided, which will make life much more easy for him. And if life is more easy and comfortable for him, he is going to be driving more. If he's going to be driving more, it's going to be benefiting all of you. So this way our testing, we incorporated everything. And that is why today we can proudly claim that the BharatBenz is a made for India truck in every aspect. Much more than what you see in trucks in India. More Indian than any Indian truck. The second objective we set for ourselves was made in India. And that came from all of you, the customers. You were very clear. You said, okay, good, European technology, American technology, Japanese technology. But no, I need the trucks to be made in India. I need every component, every spare part that goes into the truck to be Indian. Otherwise, I don't have confidence. So we went about developing parts and components. We had a big team of developers who sat down with Indian suppliers, helped them develop as per our design. And again, I'm standing here proudly to in front of you to claim, when you buy our first BharatBenz, minimum 85% would be local components in that truck. Minimum 85%. Nowhere in the world has a new brand that's come and been able to achieve this extent of localization. People ask me, what is this 85% engine you must be getting from Europe? No. Engine, transmission, gearbox, the axles, suspension, chassis, and the cabin, all of this is made in India, bought from local suppliers, Indian companies. In fact, people are shocked sometimes when I tell them what is the balance 15%. The balance 15% is mostly nuts and bolts. We import a lot. All the nuts and bolts that you see in a truck today are imported. Why do we import them? Because it's cheaper for me to import than to buy it locally. As Daimler, we make more than 4 lakh trucks a year. So for all these 4 lakh trucks, we have common sources who supply us these nuts and bolts. And we have commonized these nuts and bolts across all our models. So it gives me advantage of scale. It's much easier and cheaper for me to import this nut and bolt than to buy it in India. And that's why we continue to import. Of course, a bit of electronics is also imported in the truck. So with 85% of the components sourced locally and available in India, made by Indian suppliers, BharatBenz is very clearly made in India. Now coming to the third part which I was sharing with you. Third part is how do we make it a very different experience? How do we make a difference to all of you with a product that has been made for India and made in India? Here we decided that we have to reach this product to your doorstep. So the first thing we have done is we have started working on a network. You will have a minimum of 100 dealerships. Some of the dealers are here today with us. You will have a minimum of 100 touch points and dealerships across India. When I say dealerships, this will be complete service, spare parts, and also sales. You will have a minimum of 100 such touch points. When we launch our truck by September this year, we will have at least 70 dealerships operational. That's a commitment. And some dealerships are already ready and going. One is the dealer part. By having a dealership, is the story over? No, that's not enough. We need to do something more as BharatBenz. It is not just trucks and how to reach them. We will be also providing a host of, a number of, a bouquet of surround services, support services to help you to make this experience very different. Today, I would like to announce that we have our captive finance up and running, BharatBenz Financial Services. BharatBenz Financial Services is the in-house captive finance dedicated to BharatBenz trucks. BharatBenz Financial comes from Daimler Financial Services, which is the world's largest commercial vehicle financier, the largest commercial vehicle financier in the world. That is a Daimler company, and they have already set up shop here. We are ready, and in fact, we have already funded a few of our mining trucks which we import and sell. So in-house finance, readily available right from the first truck. We would also have branded insurance. We will also have branded service options, maintenance contracts, even going up to the entire life cycle of the product. If you are having it for 5 years, we give you a maintenance contract for 5 years. Extended warranty. We are so confident about the reliability of our product that we are openly saying and challenging that we will give you warranty, which is unheard of in the Indian truck industry. Besides this, besides captive finance, besides branded insurance, besides service contracts and extended warranty, we are also wanting to set up and we are having plans for setting up a driver academy. We recognize the need that there is going to be shortage of drivers and even existing drivers with you need to be trained. So we will be setting up a driver academy. Why are we doing all this? Why do we want to make this difference to you? We believe that we should take on all the tension from you people about buying and running trucks. Please leave that to us. We want you to concentrate on your business, your core business. Please speak to your customers, see how you can take your business forward. Leave the trucking part to us. We are here, BharatBenz is here to help you, to support you, to focus on, to make you move forward on your business. In short, BharatBenz is here to help and support you to power ahead. And that's the slogan that we have for BharatBenz. Esteemed guests, members of the trucking industry, once again, thank you so much for accepting our invitation and by honoring us by your presence. Thank you very much. It's now my proud privilege to present to you BharatBenz.
That was very exciting indeed, wasn't it? But to make these trucks wasn't an easy task. There were engineers involved, as I mentioned before. I'd like to introduce to you the two lead engineers who created these trucks for you. The lead engineer for the heavy-duty trucks, Mr. Helge Fitting, and the lead engineer for the light-duty trucks, Mr. Rainer Sundheimer. Welcome.
Namaskar.
Welcome, Rainer. Nice to have you here, gentlemen. It's a great day for us here today, and I think we have a lot to talk to about these trucks here, and I must ask you people to tell us about these trucks. So, I'd like to begin by asking you, Helge, what is the philosophy of R&D at Daimler?
Welcome, everybody. Rainer and myself, we are extremely proud to be here today to share this very special moment with you, a moment that all of our engineers cherish. It's when we can present the results of years of hard work to you. At Daimler, we strive for perfection. Perfection to us is to be able to deliver the right product to you. We study the customer requirements, the market requirements, we study the terrains, we study the operation conditions for a long time to come up with the right product for the market. Our focus is an unbeatable quality, an unmatched safety, economy, durability and comfort.
Rainer, when I see the light-duty trucks, I get the feeling of the canter. What do you have to say about it?
Yeah, you are absolutely right. The BharatBenz light-duty truck is based on the famous Fuso canter platform.
I see.
The canter is very well known in India. It is tested in India, on Indian terrain, for almost four decades. In addition, Fuso is extremely strong in the light-duty truck segment. The same is true for the medium-duty truck segment. So what have we done? We have basically taken the Canter design and have modified it according to the tough Indian conditions wherever required with the medium-duty truck design. And the result you can see here, the BharatBenz light-duty truck.
That's very nice. Helge, would you say that the heavy-duty trucks are coming from the Mercedes-Benz range?
You're absolutely right, Shankar. After our initial market study, we have looked into the Daimler portfolio, the worldwide Daimler portfolio of heavy-duty trucks, and we found the Mercedes-Benz Axor to be the most suitable platform for India. This model, the Axor model, has been tested around the world in some of the most demanding and severe conditions, and it has performed successfully. So this is the base, the DNA of our BharatBenz heavy-duty truck.
But do you mean to say that we've taken the designs and built it straight out of the existing designs, or have you done something more to it?
No. This is a very valid question. Actually, the platforms that we have chosen, they are not more than just the structural and conceptual backbones. Actually, the trucks that you see here today, they are made in India for India. Yeah? This means we have developed and tested these trucks here. We have developed the parts with Indian suppliers to get the best of designs for India.
Uh-huh. Would you say the same for the LDT?
Absolutely, yes. Yeah.
Now, if you go back in time, and I know you spent a lot of years checking the country out, going on the roads. What can you say about the time you went about understanding the country and the terrain?
This has been a very interesting time. So 4 years ago, when we came to India, we started traveling across India. Helge and I, together, we traveled along some, let's say, basic highways in India, very common highways, and we drove all the terrain available in India, expressways, then rough roads, and let's say even construction site terrain. Yeah.
And you gathered a lot of data. You met drivers.
We met a lot of people. We met drivers. We met customers as well as mechanics here and talked to them. We got very lots of information. We drove trucks in different conditions here and we gathered the data. It was an enormous task what we had, yeah.
What would you add to that, Helge?
Well, after collecting all these data and compiling all these data, we built our first C-sample trucks. C-sample trucks, just to let you understand, this is trucks from parts made from series designs, but out of prototype processes and out of prototype
tools. So the first prototype, you mean?
So you can say the first prototypes. We made these trucks, and we put them under the most rigorous testing. This means testing for functionality first, testing for durability, and testing for endurance. You can all imagine that this takes a long time to go through this process. But to us it was not important to launch the trucks quickly, but to us it was important to give the best of quality right from the day one.
I remember, Helge, when I was talking to you, you mentioned about how you were traveling around in Gujarat for almost 2 weeks and eating out of dabas, having chai at 4:30 a.m. in the morning. Was a very interesting experience, wasn't it? Okay, coming to the fact, with all this understanding, obviously I understand that you have put in one of the best test tracks in the world at Oragadam, Chennai, in our factory, where you do testing 24/7 every day of the year. What can you talk about the testing of it?
Well, the testing process actually starts at the very early stage when we collect the road load data. This is when we take, let's say, a concept truck, an initial truck, we equip it with lots of different kinds of sensors and we send it on the roads. In all different kinds of applications, we send this truck and we make our measurements, our strain measurements, and we measure the impact on the vehicle. All this data then is compiled into what we call a drive files, and with these drive files, our engineers were able to develop the test track, our test track at Oragadam. After the completion of the test track, we once again measure with the same vehicle on the test track, and this is how we get a correlation between what happens on the public road and what happens on our test track. And then by defining the speed that we drive, the number of cycles on each stretch of the track, this is how you can reproduce, let's say, every single road from India.
And Rainer, what would you add to that?
Yeah. So I would say, if I repeat a little bit what Helge said, with really the road load data, what we are having with our test track and the engineering knowledge from Daimler, there we can figure out the impact from the road on the vehicles. Basically, we can say we can experience Kashmir to Kanyakumari within the 5.6 kilometers of our test track. So we test all our vehicles here, all the prototypes, for each and every little detail. We also test competitors to check their performance. We collect the data, and the data, they will be transferred to our R&D testing center, where we check them in detail. Then we have to figure out if we have to modify some parts here, and this will be done wherever required. Parts will be modified, suppliers will be informed here about modifications required, and then again we retest with the new parts. This is a continuous process. No, by now we have already gathered cumulative mileage of 45 lakhs kilometer on our test track as well as on public road.
Let me hear you right. Did you say 45 lakh kilometers?
Absolutely true. It's 45 lakh kilometers. It might be slightly above in the mean mile.
And that is before we even launch the trucks.
Absolutely.
And right. I like the phrase that you mentioned, Kashmir to Kanyakumari within the 5.6 kilometers of a terrain. That's very, very interesting. But Helge, ye sare testing se matlab customer ka kya fayda? I'm sorry. How is the customer benefiting from all this testing that you do?
Well, first of all, important, we test and then we promise. Yeah? This means the customer, at the first day that he gets the vehicle, he gets a fully tested vehicle. We have done all kinds of tests with these vehicles. This means we ensure durability, reliability, safety, total cost of ownership in its best way. This means from the day one, the customer, you, can use the vehicle 24/7 and it is fully reliable. This means we test our trucks before our trucks test you and your patients.
So the customer actually gets value from the truck from the very first day?
Absolutely.
Okay. Can you tell me something about India-specific innovations on the HDT?
Okay. I will give a short selection. We will have more time later on to explain all the details.
At least
but
some
let
of
me
them.
Just let me just name three of them. First of all, in our engine, the unitized fuel injection pump, we are all aware of the problems that we are facing with the classical rotary pumps, lack of lubrication, frequent breakdown. This we have completely overcome, but not only this, this unitized injection pumps also fully electronically controlled, they also give a very good fuel efficiency. So this is the first point. The second point is our engine brake. This is, you can imagine, like an additional valve inside the cylinder head, which increases the brake performance, the engine brake performance, together with the classical exhaust valve that you know. This gives an excellent braking performance and gives you additional safety. Yeah? You go downhill, your liners of the service brake are cool, and this is when you brake, this is when you need it. As a third point, I want to mention the variable green band. The variable green band is an indication in your rev meter which indicates you exactly in which range you should drive the truck in the most economic and fuel-efficient way. So these are innovations, just to name some of them, that we have put into our HDT trucks.
That's very, very interesting. I think a lot of interesting facts here, more to see inside as we go along.
Absolutely.
But I must ask you to summarize. If you were to summarize all that you have done, all the innovations that you have done, how does it benefit the customer?
First of all, these trucks are made in India for India, according to the most stringent requirements and standards. We don't fool around, we don't experiment, we don't leave room for assumptions. Whatever you see here is fully tested with the customer in mind. We are best in durability, economics, safety, and we provide the lowest total cost of ownership.
And what would you add, Rainer?
What else can I add here after this detailed information from Helge Fitting? Let me summarize it this way. We build trucks for our customers according to their needs, and our trucks will deliver the lowest total cost of ownership.
I think to summarize, I would like to say that having heard you all, our promise, power ahead, basically would mean that the trucks that we deliver value to the customers from the very first day and are completely reliable, durable, efficient. That means the customer can actually focus on his primary business and expand his business and not worry about the performance of the trucks, because that is taken care of by us.
Correct.
That's very good to know. Thank you very much. It's a most exciting experience. I think we should go on to the next level where we see the whole range of trucks. It is most important for us to know that these lead engineers are so proud of their trucks here today. I think it is only fair that I give them the opportunity to unveil the trucks for you. Rainer, would you do the honors, please?
It's a great pleasure to me to unveil the complete range of BharatBenz trucks.
Very proud moment indeed, and I'm sure you're waiting to go and touch and feel the trucks. We are waiting to show it to you also. I must say at this point in time, for the convenience of all of you, we have volunteers here who will come forward. Please, they will take you forward to the trucks. Please do touch, feel, and ask all the questions that you want. We also have two forums on either side which will explain the benefits of these trucks to your particular business. We have a third forum at the back which will talk to you about the after-sales network, our sales and service network, and our captive financial service, BharatBenz Financial. But last but not the least, please also note that we have trucks, tested trucks, that are waiting right behind the hall. So any of you who intend to have a test drive, most welcome to do so. Please enjoy the show. Thank you for coming. Yeah. Thank you.